Hello everyone and welcome to Timberborn. This is a new series, Road to 500 Beavers. The name explains it. Gonna be trying to get to 500 Beavers as fast as possible. Never actually gotten anywhere near close to 500 Beavers in a game before, so this is gonna be a new experience. So with that, let's get into it. Okay, so I haven't actually played on this map before, but it's one of the biggest maps, and there is quite a bit of water. Okay, so it looks like there's plenty of ruins all throughout. I'm just gonna have to find a way to get between all the different islands. Well, to start things off, we should do the classic, just get a water pump set up and then start cutting down some trees. Just plop a few right here, get that started pretty quickly, because the limiting factor is almost always wood. Once we get the farmhouse created, then we can get some carrots and potatoes. Well, actually, I'm gonna start with sunflowers. I like sunflowers in the beginning because you don't need to cook them or grill them, but you do for potatoes. And then carrots are just easy. So I'm excited to get the series started. I've been looking forward to it for a while. And I don't know how many episodes it's gonna take, but this one I wanna actually try and finish. Since the last series I had to cut short because of the update 3, which changed the storage system. And we're on day 2, and we already have a beaver not doing anything, but we should probably make some... I mean, we don't really need berry storage, because as soon as we get this created, then it'll be fine. But I do need to make an inventor's hut, because science is key. So you want to get the forester as soon as possible, and that takes some science. So taking a look around, I think I'll be able to get probably some stairs across here, because you won't want to dam this up since that'll block the water from going this way. But getting some stairs across here, another place to farm and grow trees, and then we'll have access to scrap metal on this side. And also probably get rid of this barrier and then have like a little pool there, because I imagine this will probably all dry up when the drought happens. It's the beginning of day 3 and it looks like the farmers are getting ready to start working. Oh, there they are, right there, planting the first crops. Yeah, sunflowers. This one, carrots? Yeah, right next to each other. That's cool. I really like how they added the, for the storage, they now have like little symbols. I can't switch it. Well, I could switch it, but yeah, it looks like that. Don't want to empty it though. Keep it on logs. I did choose the folktales for this challenge specifically because the amount of beavers there are going to be is directly tied to how many beds there are. So it's going to be easier to keep track, since it's not going to be dependent on breeding pods, which that just, they'll just keep going. So this is, it's going to be an upper threshold as I increase in beavers. I am taking a look and I realize that this is all going to die during the dry season, I think, because there's not going to be any water over here and it's just going to be over here. So I'm not super excited for that. Don't really know exactly how it's gonna work, and since it's on normal mode, the droughts are gonna be, you know, pretty mild at first, but then they're gonna be around like 8 to 10 days. So probably need to figure out where I want to start damming stuff up. Nice, we got the forester ready. We don't need planks for now, so we'll pause that, and we can unpause this because in the morning I'm hoping the carrots are gonna be ready. It's at 90% right now. Oh, everyone is hungry. Let's fix that. Because the carrots aren't quite ready yet. Almost, but the berries will tie them over until then. No, go get food. Don't go chop stuff. Oh, man. Look at that, now they're harvesting. Carrots popping up. I think these beavers, they deserve a little bit of fun, so we're gonna get a campfire set up. Let's get that set up right here. Get that connected. I prioritize that so tomorrow night they'll be able to have it. Because right here is maybe where another lumber mill or gear workshop's gonna go. So just making sure it's connected a little bit will be good. Okay, we're almost at enough signs for wooden stairs. We'll be getting that. Nice. We'll be getting that in just a moment. Oh, we'll see the red not change again. Okay, it's red. It's green. Okay, let's get this. Plop down. Day 10. Still no drought. Going strong. Okay, really, since we're trying to get a lot of beavers, we should just start making more housing. But we will need to get more water set up. Shouldn't be a problem. Oh, really? I'm gonna wanna get one over here, because this way we can actually keep pumping water during the drought. What the heck? On the right side? Nope. My goodness. Okay, let's get that Kahui out of there. I want this built. And I want to build a couple of storages over here. Drought's incoming. Only one more day until the drought hits. Got a couple carrots left out. And this isn't been started yet. Man, there's a lot of beds open. I gotta get busy. The snore noise is something else. Let's get to harvesting. We can pause them for now. Yeah, we want all the jobs. We want the water being pumped, and we want the food being harvested before the dry season. Oh, we got someone grinding his teeth. Oh, that was a little painful. Okay, the day's over here, which means tomorrow will be the drought. And that's where we're gonna end this episode and start the next one. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a comment, like, and subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you. See you in the next one.